Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Today, our goal is to put together a practical guide on how to master the Wingman on Apex Legends. This is going to be quick and to the point, as fast as possible without wasting any time. The most practical advice I can give is you're going to have to practice. And that's the most thing that anybody's going to tell you. And the goal of today's video is that we're going to cover the basics of the Wingman, talk about technique, discuss how you can do this both on PC and as well if you're on console, and discuss tips and tricks, and of course, exercises. So let's get right into just the bare basics. On the Wingman, the mag starts with 5 bullets, utilizes heavy ammo, and of course level 1 mag is 6 bullets, level 2 is 7 bullets, and level 3 is 8 bullets. The sights that are best to use in this gun, meaning in terms of skins in the game, are attention to detail, precision caliber, death ray, and the dismantler. Now, the reason why you're picking these skins, as most of the Wingman skins are quite bulky. Now, if you hover your gun over the individual, you're going to find that the Wingman is going to block a majority of what you're seeing, especially if you're aiming for the head of your target. And this is why it goes to our next topic on why you see a lot of individuals flick to their shot, and also the various HCOGs that they use. So my recommendation is to utilize both the HCOG or the iron sights of the weapon utilizing these skins. The reason why most people steer away from the hollow or the 1x or the 2x is that when you shoot, you're going to find that a majority of the weapon is going to block the individual. Now, as we will discuss later in this guide and video, you're going to find that with the Wingman, visibility prediction is all key. And we're going to talk about that here briefly in a moment. Let us discuss the stylistic way of shooting with the Wingman. The first one is what I call a flick shot. And of course, the other is called more of a tracking shot. Let's start with the flicks and on PC, how you can practice this on Kovacs, as this applies more to PC players rather than console. The reason why you're utilizing flicks in terms of movement is because when aiming, it is always easier on PC to flick through what I really dislike using this word, but it's mostly used called muscle memory. One is for visibility purposes. Again, when we talk about the model of the Wingman, it'll block a majority of what you're looking at, but when you flick, you can at least see the distance and you can see the target of what you're aiming for. This is why, again, the thinner version of the Wingman that we were just discussing is much better. Now, in Kovacs, we're going to discuss a scenario that is very perfect in regards to how to utilize the Wingman. Actually, it's kind of funny because the scenario is called Man Wing. Very coincidental that it's called that. It's much more effective to simply flick to your shot than track. If you're trying to track a target moving at this speed, is going to prove very difficult for you to achieve. Now, this is much more doable on console to track than flicking, so those of you on console, you're going to want more to track your target, obviously, than flicking, because flicking is not necessarily manageable. It definitely is. I've seen a lot more people utilize tracking, though. On PC, the reason why they do it is obviously because they can't see the target, but on console, you should be able to feel a little bit of aim assist to be able to assist you in hitting your target. It's not heavy, and of course, this depends on your sensitivity. So for those that are on console, you're going to want to track. Of course, when you have a sensitivity that's much lower, you're going to feel more aim assist. I know individuals like to meme in terms of how aim assist works and that it's too much, but nonetheless, it's just a little bit present. That's a video for another time. But in terms of how, if you have a higher sensitivity, obviously you're going to feel less of that tug or pull in terms of overall aim assist. This is why most people utilize around a 3, but the issue is that you're not going to be utilizing that flick as you would see on PC. Of course, if you have a higher sensitivity, the trouble here is that you're going to want to utilize a scuff controller or something along those lines to be able to give you more precision, as it is pretty difficult on controller to get that precision outside of tracking, though, when you're trying to get more of those flicks. It's not saying that it's impossible. So again, if you have a clean sight like an HCOG, you want to opt to track the target if you're practicing this. A way to practice on Kovacs is using dodge to track scenario. I'm going to highlight that here on screen. It's a more positive way to get a better representation of tracking while shooting, rather than the man wing scenario where you're flick shooting. Now obviously the best practice is going to be in-game. It is important to remember that the velocity of the Wingman is slower than your average bullet in most FPS games. You are going to need to lead your shot. Now, the more interesting part when leading your shot and accounting for consistency is understanding if your opponent lags. Then you will need to compensate even further, or vice versa, if you're lagging. I'm not really going to be able to get into the nitty-gritty of latency, as there are others that are way more qualified to explain this, but know that it impacts your shot. With a Wingman, there's a level of predicting, and also luck when somebody's strafing into your shot. Due to the speed, at times, you'll need a level of luck, also with that prediction. Obviously, the closer a target, less luck, and more predicting. At a distance, there are several factors that you really have to consider. Obviously, we talked about it at the start of this video, but it is predicting lag and overall to lead your shot. So at times you can whiff really hard due to the sheer fact that someone predicts incorrectly. And keep in mind, when facing somebody in a battle royale, you do not know their immediate internet connection. And that can impact a fight at a distance when somebody is strafe spamming. In Apex Legends, targets move quite fast. So you have to understand that there is a level of RNG when utilizing the Wingman at said distance. Of course, if they're running in a predictable pattern, this makes life a lot easier. Now, we got that out of the way, let's talk about practice. You can obviously stand still and practice with an HCOG and flick back and forth. That's practice session number one. And of course, on a different part of the map, you can track a moving wall. You can practice with the bots. We've discussed this many times on my channel, where you turn them on to have them move around. This is going to be really strong to give you a base on your Wingman shots and having a target actually move and lead a little bit with your shots. So to practice your movement and shots, best to get a friend to do 1v1s with. Grab an arc star and start at two different path points. Throw an arc star, and on the explosion start, that's when you begin fighting. So the goal here when you're doing 1v1s in the test range is to predict movement. Practice against both controller players and PC movement. Both are going to require different levels of prediction in terms of overall movement. Because on PC, obviously, you know they can kind of strafe spam and crouch spam. On console, their strafing is just going to be a little different. So you need to get used to both of these, especially as you're improving your shot. You're not going to be able to learn any of this in terms of Kovacs. Visibly, yes, you're going to feel a lot more comfortable, but understanding prediction levels in game only comes with time. So again, the goal is to predict movements. Practice against controller players and PC movement. Both require different predictions in terms of movement. Another tip, another fantastic one, empty your mag and only have one gun in the slot and practice shooting. You can fire the gun without firing a bullet. This is really good to practice because you can just keep spam firing outside of getting used to the normal shot or having to go reload the gun constantly. So again, let us recap. The obvious goal is to practice both in-game and a clean environment like Kovacs for those on PC. Understand there's a level of predicting and lag, and you have to compensate very quickly when going into a gunfight. Then do specific exercises to achieve your goal. So whenever I say practice a specific exercise, let's say you have difficulty leading a shot at distance. So at that point, go at a distance in the test range and start to practice those shots. Let's say you have issues flicking to a target who is close range and you struggle with your FOV. So get up and close and personal with the bots and start flicking to your targets. Let's say you struggle with consistency on flicking your shots, not on moving targets, but something that is standing still because it requires micro movement. Not a problem. Hit the target standing still. Let's say you want to practice those tracking shots like we were just discussing earlier in the video. Not a problem as well. Track on the wall and try to keep it as steady as possible. Again, there's different results to achieve here for both PC and console, but all these concepts will remain the same. And now nonetheless, I know we cut this video a little longer, but the biggest feedback I can say is practice. You're going to have to practice in-game. Nothing is going to be able to substitute what happens in-game when in terms of latency and what you're getting used to in terms of landing your shots. Don't lead too much, but lead enough to ensure that you're landing your shot. Record your gameplay and review everything, because you're going to find as you go over your gameplay that it looks like your shot was dead on, but you perhaps needed to lead a little bit. And keep in mind with latency and no regs on whose screen did I hit what, if they were behind a corner, that this is always going to become a factor. I really appreciate everybody for watching this guide and video. I hope you found this video helpful and helps you achieve more of your goal to master the Wingman. Because you can master it, you will master it, and that's why this video is here. So again, thank you so much for watching. Be sure to leave a like, subscribe for more content. Let me know what more guides you would like to see. Again, I really feel that this is a huge recipe for improvement. I would like to continue this on the channel. We're going to put together more montages. I appreciate everybody again here, and I'll see you guys next time.